Dermot the Director says, Father Simon, Brother Matthew and Sister Susie of the Holy Board of Censors, hearing the confession from Mick the Grip the other day reminded me of an incident. That was the confession that happened on a when they were filming a movie. Reminded me of an incident that happened about 5 years ago. Father Simon, I am what is known as an independent filmmaker. Basically, I'm an enthusiast with all his own camera gear, filming with next to no budget. With a bunch of friends, we'd made numerous short films over the years that have entered and been shown at various film festival venues. Unfortunately, even after several attempts at trying, we've never won any awards. Well, I was determined our luck would change. I was upping the budget, borrowing a more expensive camera, and looking further afield for the cast. I placed a casting call on a recognised casting website, was amazed to find it attracted a lot of interest. One actor caught my eye for the lead female role. Her name was Nadine. Her acting CV was impressive, and her photographs matched the description of her lead character. On the day of the auditions, we all met with the potential actors for the other parts in our film in a local hall. In the foyer, Nadine had arrived. She looked just as incredible in person as she did in the photographs. As the conversation progressed, it was clear she was ideal for our female lead. I offered her the part without hesitation, and she accepted. I then told her how much we would pay her. She agreed to the fee, but added this was a little less than she was accustomed to. Nadine had worked, she said, on very prestigious productions over the years, but decided she'd participate in our low-budget film because she liked the script. Even though I had explained about the tight budget, I found it puzzling why Nadine insisted on having her own catering team and wardrobe. I had to repeat again, it's low budget. She'd have to bring her own clothes and a packed lunch. Our location was a 5-bedroom house belonging to one of the crew. I'm going to call him Tom. He was our camera operator for the day. On entering the house, he asked us if we wanted a cup of tea. Nadine said yes, and a cooked breakfast, please. Apparently, she couldn't work on an empty stomach. Tom looked at me, I looked back at Tom. Tom looked at his wife, Sally, who reluctantly agreed to make Nadine her breakfast. The rest of the cast arrived as we set up for our first scene in Tom's living room, whilst Nadine ate her breakfast. This scene involved Nadine and our male lead called Jack. Nadine's character had to burst through the living room door and confront Jack over an extramarital affair. With script in hand, the scene was rehearsed. All looked good. I turned to the crew. Are you ready to film? Tom was on camera. Yes, ready. The other crew said, yes, ready. Jack said, ready. Nadine, before I could say another word, Nadine said, no, not ready. I have to be in the zone.
Oh, no.
What? She then left the room and went out of the front door for a vape. I looked at my watch. While she was in the zone, we were now behind schedule. Eventually, everyone returned. The camera began recording and the scene had begun. Nadine entered the room and slammed the door behind her. Cut! I said, Nadine, don't slam the door. Okay, take two. Several more takes of Nadine slamming the door and me shouting, cut. Eventually, I decided to let the scene play out. Jack delivered his first line of dialogue. Nadine's jaw dropped. What are you doing? She asked Jack. Jack said, acting. Nadine said, your facial expression looks peculiar. Would you stop it? Jack turned to me rather embarrassed. This was getting nasty. However, to keep Nadine happy, I suggested one more take. The crew looked fed up. Jack looked fed up. Anyway, I said, action. The scene began. Nadine entered the room and slammed the door again. This time the door handle flew across the room.
Oh,
made a loud crashing noise. I looked at Tom. His hand slapped his forehead in disbelief. I felt embarrassed as this was Tom's house and clearly everyone had now had enough. So I told Nadine that Tom's wife was now upstairs and we better try to get her attention as we had no way of getting out of the room through the door now that the knob had fallen off. Someone would have to climb out of the window, go to the front door and press the doorbell. And as you busted the door, maybe it should be you, Nadine, just a suggestion. Anyway, we opened the window and with great effort, she managed to climb out. She wasn't that nimble. You should know, by the way, it's now raining incredibly hard outside. In fact, it's torrential. It's then, once she's outside, Tom laughed and admitted that the door handle was already broken, and actually, he had a screwdriver with him to fix it. As Tom was repairing the handle, the doorbell rang. Nadine, she was stuck outside the house in the rain. Well, our door was fixed. We all walked into the kitchen for a cuppa. This took a while, obviously. Selection of the cups, warming of the pot. Now it is raining hard outside, isn't it? Then we have to choose the right tea. You can't hurry this process, especially when you know, little Miss La-di-da Fancy Pants is now getting very wet. After an incredibly long time, I thought I'd better open the front door to let the incredibly drenched Nadine in. I explained Tom had managed to repair the handle after all. It took another hour for Nadine to get dry, and then another hour for her to get back in the zone.
Oh, good.
Justice, though? I think so. Father Simon, I don't ask for forgiveness from Nadine. As the rest of the shoot went without any more demands and mishaps, Princess Pushy had learned a lesson, and she got a cold. However, I do ask for forgiveness from Jack, who was humiliated in front of the cast and crew. Also, Tom and Sally, who had the patience of saints, and to the other cast and crew members for having to endure take after take from prima donna Pushy Pants, if that works. Incidentally, I entered the short film into a festival, but unfortunately, we didn't win any awards at all. Dermot, the director, seeks for forgiveness because he made Princess Pushy Pants end up getting a cold, but she was very demanding. Sister Susie from the pub, voice of producers.
Well, she does seem a little bit of a nightmare, but, you know, you wanted someone of high standard, and maybe they come with a few demands when they're that good. And I just think it's a bit mean to leave someone out in the rain. I'd be fuming if you left me out in the rain and got a cold. I wouldn't be happy, so
yeah,
I'm sorry.
That'd be right, yeah.
Dermot, the director, don't forgive you. It's bit mean.
Brother from another gutter.
I'd say this to begin with. I think if they decided to release the making of this particular movie, that might win some awards. I'd certainly watch that. So she's rocking up demanding cooked breakfast. How very unlike actors to be full of themselves and demanding. Who'd have thought that was going to come? Didn't teach you that at RADA, did they? So I am going to forgive. Because, you know, drama students and the rest of them.
Who would have thought that Matt would take against a drama actor type person? Anyway, it's...